Today we will discuss the last topic of the chapter, alternating currents. So what is the last topic? That is related to transcurrents. Okay. So transformer is a device which converts alternating current at low voltage into high voltage or vice versa. So we can write a device which converts alternating current at low voltage to high voltage or vice versa. Okay, it is a device which converts alternating current at low voltage. So we can increase voltage or decrease voltage by using transformers. So there are two types of transformers. One is step up transformer is there, and another one is step down transformer. So the word itself says what is meant by that. Step up means voltage will be more and step down means voltage will be less. Okay. So here these transformers works on the principle of mutual induction. So what is meant by mutual induction? Whenever a varying current is applied to a primary coil, there will be a current will be produced in the secondary coil because of electromagnetic induction. Okay. So mutual induction. So what is meant by mutual induction? That you have to explain. Here I will not explain because already we discussed. Mutual induction means variation. If a varying current is applied across a primary, a current will be produced in the secondary. That phenomenon is known as electromagnetic induction. So already we discussed there are two types of transformers, step up and step down. So how a transformer is indicated? So here, if it is a step down or step, if it is a step up transformer, how it will be looking like, you can see. Okay. So this here what happens, this coil we will say it as primary coil. So secondary coil, more number of currents will be there. So this we will call it as secondary. This is for step up transformer. Okay, here we can get the output. And in the case of step down transformer, what is the difference? In step down transformer, in primary, more number of turns will be there. It is connected to an AC source. This we can call it as primary. And in secondary, less number of turns. From here, we will take the output. Okay. Is it clear? So you can clearly distinguish between step up transformer and step down transformer by analyzing the number of turns. Here you can see that in secondary more number of turns are there. So we can say that this is a step up transformer, and here you can see that in secondary less number of turns are there. It is a step down transformer. So this type of arrangement is known as core type transformer. These two. Okay. We can say it as core type transformer. quartile transformer. And so what is here, what is this rectangular block, what it is shown, that is the soft iron core. So above that soft iron core, one part we are, one side we are winding primary, some coils will be wound and that will be connected to AC source, that we will call it as primary. Another source, another part, there also wires will be wound. From there we'll take the output because of induction, mutual induction, current will be produced whenever varying AC is applied in the primary. Okay. And this is core type transformer. So another type is the shell type transformer. So in shell type transformer, what it makes the difference is that in shell type transformer, this primary and secondary will be wound one over the other. Primary and secondary will be wound over the, here soft iron raw core will be there, okay. Above that soft iron core, primary and secondary will be wound one above the another, but there is no contact will be between primary and secondary, okay. Primary and secondary will be, even though it will be wound one over another, there will be some insulating medium which separates primary and secondary, okay. Is it clear? So here soft iron core will be the above that soft iron core, primary will be wound, above that secondary will be wound. Okay. Is it clear? So this type of transformer we will call it as shell type transformer. Later on we will discuss what is the advantage of shell type transformer, or what is the problem of core type transformer, and all those we will discuss. Okay. So this is a, what is meant by transformer and what is its basic principle. Now we can see the mathematical expression of it. Okay. So we will see the mathematical expression of this. Okay. So now we will discuss the working of transformer. Okay. So we are considering either step up or step down. One type transformer we are considering. So here I am considering a step up transformer. Let NP and NS be the number of turns in the primary and secondary coil. And if we are applying a voltage VP, VP is the voltage applied across primary. And if we are considering that secondary is open, and if we assume that current flowing through primary or resistance of the primary coil is very, very small, so in that case we can write the induced EMF in the primary, that we can write induced EMF in primary can be written as minus NP d phi by dt. Same way we can write induced EMF in secondary can be written as minus NS d phi by dt. So if there is, here we are assuming that whatever may be the flux associated with primary, same flux is passing through secondary also. Okay. Is it clear? So here whenever AC voltage is applied, because of here due to varying AC voltage, because of self-induction, induced EMF will be there, and here because of mutual induction, induced EMF will be there, that expression we have written. So we can write EP by ES is equal to NP by NS. Here we are assuming that the flux associated with primary and secondary are equal, there is no flux leakage. Okay. Or we can write if VP by VS is equal to NP by NS. We are assuming that secondary is open, there is no load in the secondary, and the resistance in the primary is very small. If it is not small, what happens? We cannot write VP is equal to EP. So there will be some resistance, some potential drop will be because will be there because of the, because or due to the resistance of the coil. Okay. So we are assuming all those conditions. So we can write VP by VS equal to NP by NS. Is it clear? This is for a transformer. And or we can write VS by VP is equal to NS by NP. and this ratio of number of turns in secondary to the number of turns in primary is known as turns ratio. NS by NP we can write. NS by NP is known as turns ratio or transformation ratio. Turns ratio or transformation ratio means the ratio of the number of turns in secondary to the number of turns in primary, that is known as turns ratio or transformation ratio. Sometimes in problems they will give transformation ratio is this much value, calculate like that. So you should know that what is meant by transformation ratio. Okay. So this is the expression. So from this expression clearly you can see that if NS is greater than NP, what happens? Vs will be greater than Vp, which means secondary voltage will be greater than primary voltage if number of turns in secondary is greater than number of turns in primary. That's why I told you when we are dealing with step up transformer, number of turns in secondary should be shown more than number of turns in primary. Okay, so whenever you are drawing the diagram of transformer also, either in primary or in secondary, you have to show more number of turns. So you should not draw both equal. Is it clear? So this is the expression. And if a transformer is ideal one, for ideal transformer means what is meant by ideal transformer? Whatever may be the input, output also will be same, which means output power will be equal to input power. You can write output power is equal to input power output power is equal to input power for ideal transformer, or we can write Vs Is is equal to Vp V, or we can write Vs by Vp is equal to Ip by Is. So if you substitute here, what you can write? Vs by Vp is equal to Ns by Np is equal to Ip by Is. But this is Ns by Np is equal to Ip by Is, that we can write if and only if for an ideal transformer, or we can say that for an ideal transformer, efficiency will be 100%. How efficiency will become 100%? Output power is equal to input power. So efficiency is given by, how you will write efficiency? Efficiency is equal to output power divided by input power. So we will get both are equal, Vs Is by Vp Ip, which is equal to 1. So we can write efficiency is equal to 100% for ideal transformer. Okay. Only for ideal transformer we can write efficiency is 100%. Okay. Is it clear? Understood? No. Now we will discuss whether actual transformer whether will behave like an ideal transformer, or if it does not behave like an ideal transformer, which are the problems or why its efficiency is not 100%. Energy losses in transformers. So already we discussed efficiency is equal to output power by input power. For ideal transformer efficiency is 100%, but practically we cannot reach 100%. It will be for normal type of transformers, it varies from 90 to 95, 96, that much range we will get. So, but we cannot get 100% efficiency. Why? For what? Which? Because of which type of energy losses we are not getting output power is equal to input power. That we are discussing. First one is flux linkage. Flux linkage means the magnetic flux associated with primary and secondary will not be equal. In core type transformer, already we have seen, we have discussed, no? In core type transformer, what happens? Here it is connected, no, primary is connected, and here we are connecting secondary. From here we are taking output. So there will be some flux leakage will be there because of this type of configuration. So to minimize flux leakage means magnetic flux associated with secondary will not be equal to primary. Okay. If they are equal only, we are cancelling, no, d phi by dt, we are cancelling from both expression and we are getting Vs by Vp is equal to Ns by Np, no? So, if there is flux leakage, we will not get output power is equal to input power. So, to minimize flux leakage, we are using shell type configuration. So, when we are using shell type configuration, what happens? Here, one, here primary is, if you are connecting primary, we are connecting here. Above this only secondary is wound, so flux leakage can be minimized by using shell type configuration rather than core type configuration. Okay, and second one is copper loss. What is meant by copper loss? Copper loss means because of the resistance. Because of the resistance, some heat energy will be dissipated, which is equal to I squared RT. Now, if R is the resistance of the primary, the heat energy dissipated in primary is given by H is equal to I squared RT. So, heat energy will be dissipated because of the resistance. Okay, that is known as copper loss. And another one is eddy current. Eddy current loss. Because of eddy current, heat energy will be produced. How eddy current develops? We are using soft iron core, no? So, if it is a bulk material, this continuously undergoes magnetization, continuously undergoes, there will be varying magnetic flux is there, no? So, magnetic field lines associated, it will be continuously changing. Because of the induction, electromagnetic induction, electric current will be produced, which is known as eddy current, that already we discussed. Because of the production of eddy current, again heat energy is produced. That is known as eddy current loss. So, to minimize eddy current loss, we can do core lamination, already we discussed. Instead of making a bulk soft iron core, it will be made into thin layers. And in between those two thin, in between thin layers, insulating material will be inserted, because of which it will offers very high resistance and heat energy due to eddy current can be minimized. Okay, this is about eddy current loss. The next one is hysteresis loss. Hysteresis loss. So hysteresis loss means this soft iron core is a ferromagnetic material. So, it undergoes magnetization and demagnetization. So, continuously. So, in one cycle, it undergoes magnetization and demagnetization. And during the process of magnetization and demagnetization, energy is wasted. Okay. So, to minimize hysteresis loss, we are choosing a material in such a way that material should have low hysteresis loss. Because of that reason, we are using soft iron core. Soft iron core is used because of its low hysteresis curve. Low hysteresis loop is there. Because of that, we are using soft iron core. And another one is that humming loss. Humming loss means this continuously undergoes a process of magnetization and demagnetization. So because of that, magnetostriction happens and hence it produces sound, that is known as humming loss. Okay, so these are the various humming loss. Okay, humming loss. So these are the various reasons why efficiency of a transformer is not able to achieve 100%. Even though we cannot make it 100%, it will be more than 90% only. Okay, is it clear? Now we will discuss one or two problems related to transformer. Okay. We'll discuss problem. Okay. A transformer has efficiency of 100%. The number of turns in primary and secondary are 500 turns and 10,000 turns respectively. Find the secondary voltage. Find the secondary voltage if the primary voltage is 220 volt. Okay, so here it is given that it is efficiency is 100%. Now number of turns in primary is given, secondary is given. Then what is given? Secondary voltage, you have to find primary voltages. Direct formula is the Vs by Vp is equal to Ns by Np. So Vs is equal to Ns into Vp divided by Np. Ns, number of turns in secondary is 10,000 into Vp primary it is 220. Divided by Np is 500. What you will get? 4,000. 4,400 unit is volt. Okay. Is it clear? 4,400 volt is the voltage in second. Now we'll discuss the next problem. Step down transformer changes the voltage from 220 volt to 11 volt. If the current in primary is 5 ampere and the current in secondary is 90 ampere, calculate the efficiency. Calculate the efficiency. So here how to find efficiency? Efficiency we can write output power by input power. No? Output power divided by input power. So what is output power? Vs into Is and input power is Vp Ip. So we can write efficiency is equal to Vs is given. What is secondary voltage? It is 11 and secondary current it is given 90 divided by Vp it is 220 and current is 5. We can divide it. So here what you will get 20. So 90 by 5 2s are 10. So 90 by 100. So that you will get the efficiency as 90%. Okay. So this is the way of solving problems related to transformers. So here if it is not mentioned about efficiency, you can assume that it is an ideal transformer and you can find, you can solve it. Okay. Sometimes they may give efficiency will be given, three quantity, among them three quantities will be given, you have to find one unknown. Or sometimes in order to find current also, they may not give directly, they will give voltage and resistance in secondary, or it is connected to a device of resistance, this much value like that they will give. By using that you have to find current and then you have to solve it. Okay. So whatever it is, this is the way of solving problems related to transformers. So two things you have to keep it in mind. You should remember about transformation ratio, turns ratio, that is NS by NP, and about efficiency. If it is given efficiency as, if it is given efficiency, accordingly you can find by using this formula. If it is not mentioned, you can assume that it is an ideal transformer. Okay, is it clear? So you can refer some more problems from your textbook and reference book, and if you are having any doubt, you can come back. Okay, thank you.